color. Original hand-painted face. Natural dyed blanket stitched vest. Little rip. Fixable. Oh, if only you had your hand-stitched polyvinyl hat! I found them!
A point of view, or POV shot, is any shot that shows the world from the vantage point of a character in the scene. A POV is usually preceded by a setup shot.
Huh?
It's a simple editing pattern. First comes the setup shot, which is the shot on the character doing the looking, which is followed by the actual POV shot from the looker's point of view. Hitchcock is well known for the use of the POV. In this scene from North by Northwest, the entire sequence is made up of shots of Cary Grant looking off screen, followed by shots on the airplane from his point of view. When we see a character look off screen and then cut to a view of the environment, as long as the camera angle in the second shot roughly matches the character's eye line in the first, then the second shot is assumed to be through the eyes of the character. The French director Jean-Luc Godard called the cut on the look the most natural cut in film, because when a character looks off screen, it provides such a powerful motivation for a cut to see what the actor or group of actors is looking at.
To perform some kind of a half-assed autopsy on a fish.
A POV shot can represent a single character's point of view or the collective view of a group of characters, as in this shot from the movie Jaws. There are basically two kinds of POV shots. There's the literal first-person POV, where the surrounding characters stare directly at the camera when addressing the POV character. And then there's what I would call the quasi-first-person POV, where the camera shows what the POV character is seeing, but the eye lines of the other characters who are looking at the POV character are slightly off-axis, making the shots not quite literal POVs. The Lady in the Lake, a film noir thriller from 1947, was an experiment in which the entire film was shot from a single character's literal first-person point of view. The idea has not been repeated, probably because seeing events from a single POV is just too limiting to be sustained for an entire movie.
I need help.
It's just a little too weird to have all the actors in a film looking directly at the camera for the entire time.
Give me your hands.
But in small doses, a literal first-person POV can be effective. Put in the audience, in the shoes of a character in the film, invites direct empathy with their predicament, as in this shot from The Incredibles, or this one from the movie Up. There are certain standard first-person POV shots that literally put the audience behind the eyeballs of a character in the movie. There is, for example, the actual eyeball POV shot.
But he said Santa would have to
and the keyhole obstructed view POV.
Peaky hole ready for battle!
Yeah.
These are shots that approach the idea of POV literally. And the literalness is what sometimes makes them funny.
To the left. No, your left. Take them higher.
What's happening?
Oh, it's horrible. They're torturing him.
What?
There's the upside down POV.
Did you chop it? Oh no.
The binocular POV. And its variations, the telescope POV, and the gun sight POV. There's the camera POV.
I cannot be offended.
Hyperspectral cameras?
The robot vision POV.
Ah!
And then there's the reading POV, where we, the audience, get to read a document through the eyes of a character in the scene.
He's your son?
I have a son?
A shaky handheld camera can be used to sell the idea that a shot represents the searching gaze of a living character. And a snap zoom can represent the way that the eye searches and then focuses in on an important detail.
This is not what I meant!
The moving POV puts the audience in the scene in a very physical way. You start with a shot of the character that's moving, and then, in the next shot, you become the moving character.
Try to be less careless.
I'm watching you, Wazowski. Always watching.
This be impossible!
A moving POV is a good device for creating motivated camera movement and giving a shot more energy. In this scene from The Fantastic Mr. Fox, the camera picks up the start and stop rhythm of the character's movement, creating an amusing cinematic gag. Sometimes a filmmaker will deliberately create the impression that a shot is a POV and then contradict it.
Whatever you do, do not look down.
Whoa!
Let's take another look at this shot from Rango. In the setup shot, we see Rango and the others looking around as they enter the cave. Then, in the next shot, the audience naturally assumes that we're looking at the scene from Rango's point of view, only to have that assumption contradicted when Rango walks into frame. It's almost like playing a trick. You think you're seeing the world through the character's eyes, and then all of a sudden, the character appears in the shot.
Identification, please.
And then there are interesting shots like this one from How to Train Your Dragon. It starts as a shot on the Hiccup character from behind and then pushes past him to, in effect, take on his point of view, finally returning to the character for a reaction.
Well, this was stupid.
It's an over-the-shoulder, a POV, and a reaction shot all in one. Whether we're talking about a literal or a quasi-first-person point of view, the POV shot is a powerful tool for creating empathy.
Be safe.
Within my heart when she
motivating the camera and bringing humor to a scene.
Little like you.
I dreamed a new dream, saw a new face, and I'm spreading sunshine all over the place with a new point of view. Here's what greets my eye: new love, new luck, new sun in the sky.